video, we're going to be discussing the delightfully named topic of shell globbing, also known as file name expansion. Say you want to do something with a bunch of files that all share a similar name. Perhaps you're deleting all of them, or you're moving them to another file. Shell globbing lets you work with multiple files at once by recognizing and expanding a set of wildcards. These are asterisks, which will match to zero or more characters. You've also got square brackets, where you can put characters inside here and it'll match to listed characters. And finally, question mark, which will match to exactly one character. Note that although this seems kind of similar to regular expressions, globbing and regular expressions are not the same. The shell by itself doesn't recognize regular expressions, and globbing is kind of its solution to doing pattern matching with file names. It's bonus confusing because they share some wildcards that actually work differently in each case. If you want to learn about regular expressions, you can check out our other videos on that. Okay, let's have a look at some of these globbing wildcards in action. I'm in a directory full of random files that we're going to have a play with. One of the most common uses of globbing is to find files with a certain suffix. Say I want to match all of my .jpg files. I can do echo star for any number of characters .jpg. Wonderful. I've echoed all files that start with any number of characters and end with .jpg. But what if I also have .jpeg, as you often have with JPEGs? This is where the wildcard property of matching zero or more characters comes in handy. I can use the star in here as well, and this will match the case where there is no character there, and also the case where there is a single E. Watch out though, it may not always match what you expect. In my case, it was reasonably unlikely that I'd have a JPOG or a JPEG in there. However, say I'm looking for all files with the word cat in them, so I echo star cat star like this. Cool! I have a cat.jpg, mycat.txt, however I also have education.txt, which does, strictly speaking, have the word cat in it, but wasn't what I was looking for. Globbing is not as powerful as regex, and often we have to make assumptions about what will exist in file names in order to do matching. Okay, getting back to my JPEGs. Let's say not only do I have JPEGs with or without an E, I also have uppercase.jpg. What can I do? Well, I can use square brackets to match from a set of characters. I can list anything starting with any number of characters, then a dot, then choosing from uppercase or lowercase j, uppercase or lowercase p, uppercase or lowercase g. Now, this matches an uppercase.jpg, and note that it also matches dot uppercase j, lowercase p, g, where in this case the j has been matched from the uppercase j in the first set of square brackets, and lowercase p and g have matched from the lowercase characters in the second two square brackets. I can throw in the extra asterisks as well to account for any e's that might be hovering around. Note that I can't do a square bracket to account for this e. Exactly one character from each set of square brackets will be matched. There's no zero characters case. And this means because we're using the asterisks, it's not a precise match. Another common thing I might want to do is find all of my .c and .h files and put them somewhere. Let's make a directory C files to put them in. And we're going to move them there by using move, all files starting with any number of characters, a dot, then within square brackets either C or H, and we're going to put them in C files. Cool. Now if I list everything inside C files, you'll see it's just my .c and .h files. I can also use the square brackets to match on a range. I've got another set of files here, just starting with all the letters of the alphabet. Perhaps I wanted to only match with files from starting from G to M. I could do list G, H, I, J, K, L, M, within square brackets and then star, but that's tedious. And because you've got a continuous range of letters here, I can make that a range by just doing G dash M. Does the same thing. The same thing works with single character numbers, and you can combine ranges. So say you want G to M and also T to Z. That will do that for me. Another thing I can do here is use the not or exclamation mark character to match anything not in the specified set of letters or range. Using this, I can select anything not starting with a vowel, A, E, I, O, U, or anything not in the range M to T, or not starting with a character in the range M to T. Cool. The last wildcard we're going to talk about is the question mark, which matches to any one single character. Before, back in my other folder, I used square brackets to match to .c or .h files. I could also have used the question mark to match to any file that ends with one single character. I'll have to look inside my C files folder. There. And that'll do the same thing, provided that the only files that end with a single character are .c and .h files. A similar use that's less likely to come up with incorrect results is listing all MP3 or MP any number files, 3, 4, or 5. I can list any number of characters, .mp, and then a single file, or a single character rather. And I've got an MP3, an MP4, and an MP5. It's reasonably unlikely that I'd have an MPQ or an MP0 or something weird, so that's why I can sort of assume that. One last thing I can do with this is list all files that have a three-letter suffix with three question marks. And I see, I think that's about all my files there, but they all have three-letter suffixes. The last thing I'm going to cover is, what if I want to match a character that is a wildcard? To do this, I have to use the backslash character to escape it. Say if I wanted to look at all files that have an actual asterisk in the name, I can do echo unescaped asterisk for any number of characters, backslash asterisk for an actual asterisk, and then asterisk for another set of any characters. You can see here I get all my files that have an actual asterisk in the name. So now you can go out and glob to your heart's content.